Sometimes I don't even feel like I make this stuff, man. I just feel like it's zoning out to it, man.
How did they get this beat? You just showed it to them? They're like, yo, that's the one right there?
We were in London, like, last January, me and Big Sean, and we just did this idea, and he just like, ain't nobody, you know, my clique. And then initially, Kanye heard it, and he wasn't as crazy about it, but then he just kept revisiting it, and we just, like, beefed it up, and, you know, turned into this.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Rico and Mambo Morning Show, producer, artist, we got Hit Boy in the house!
What's good, man?
What's up, man?
Man, I'm happy to be here. It's early, you know what I'm saying? We out here.
Hey, first of all, congratulations on everything that's been going on
Thank you, man.
Appreciate it. Man, you've working with some of the best in the music industry.
Yeah, it's definitely a blessing, man.
And how is it working like with a Kanye West and a Jay-Z?
Man, you just get to learn so much. Those guys are veterans, and they've been doing it. Like, I was studying them when I was 14, 15 years old.
Wow.
And for me to be, like, alongside them now, it's just, you know, it's amazing.
What kind of student were you when you were going to school?
Man, I was just quiet. Like, I was doing music already, so I just, like, went, did what I did, and I went home, knocked my homework out, and I was doing beats all night. You know
what I'm saying?
Wow. Yeah, that was, like, just my life. I probably went to 2 or 3 parties because I just knew, like, that wasn't like what I was supposed to be doing at the time.
Right.
I needed to do this music, and when I start to party, I'm gonna party for real. You know what I'm saying? So now when I go out, it's like it's an event.
Now the party's playing your music.
Right.
Party can't do without your music.
It's pretty interesting, man. I was asking him off air what was the first song, you know, from a big artist that he had produced, and he said he did something for J-Lo.
Yeah, 2007, man. I did a song called Forever off of her Brave album.
So where are you originally from?
I'm from, I grew up in Pasadena, stayed there till I was like 13. Then I moved to the IE. So I rep the Fontana, IE, you know, surrounding areas, Rancho, you know what I'm saying? But like Pasadena/IE.
Out of the radio hits that are out there right now that you produce, which one's your favorite one right now?
Man, right now, one of my favorite songs is Backseat Freestyle by Kendrick Lamar, man.
Oh,
like, I'm so excited about what he's doing for not only just the coast, but like just music in general. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's making really great hip hop, so I'm proud of that.
So so you've got under your belt 50, Lupe Fiasco, Lil Wayne, Nicki Minaj, just to name a few.
Man.
What's next?
What's next is, man, really just popping off my own thing with this rap stuff that I'm doing and trying to build a label. I got Audio Push, man. I'm building my brand, HS87. I got K. Roosevelt. And just, like, just really just putting on for the new guys. I just, like, you know, this upcoming year, I want to do, like, you know, at full-length projects or do, like, half of an album for, like, maybe, like, somebody like Britney Spears or something like that. But just, like, trying different things.
Well, you know what? If those stars keep aligning, man, you're going to find yourself in that position.
Oh, he's definitely headed in that position,
exactly.
Man. You know, and then off the air right now, as when we were talking, you said that it's sometimes hard to believe that you made these beats.
Yeah, for sure, man. Just because, like, I mean, I've made a lot of music in, like, the last 10 years since I started making beats. But, like, man, sometimes you just get those joints where it's like, I don't even know how this came out of me. You know what I'm saying?
So you mentioned you've been producing music for like 10 years.
Well, I started making beats when I was 16. I'm 25, so I'm, you know, almost 10 years.
And is music something that's been in your family for a minute?
Yes. My uncle was in a group called Troop back in the day.
And, well, that's,
you know,
Rico.
Like, early 90s, you know what I'm saying? They had a few hits, so definitely.
A few.
Come on, man. This guy's just so humble about everything, man. Now, your first instrument or your first piece of equipment, music equipment, do you remember what it was?
Just a computer with a program called Fruity Loops that I still use to this day. And my grandmother actually bought me that computer. So she was, you know, in support since day one.
So there, grandma's got plans for everybody.
Right.
So how does it feel? Like, earlier this year, it's been said that Kanye said that you're the next me.
Word. Just, man, I mean, just to be in his realm, just period, is amazing. And, you know, I can't really say that I'm the next him, but just being able to be around him and learn, it's an amazing thing. You know what I'm saying? It's like, when I get around him, man, I got to, like, take it up, like, a million notches because he's just there. He's a forward thinker, and he's always just challenging me.
Do you get nervous, like, whenever they're around and, like, in the studio overlooking?
It's definitely still, like, I mean, I've been around him a million times, and every time it's just like, man, this is really Kanye West right now. Like, it's crazy.
What's next for Hit-Boy in 2013?
really just building my own brand, man, just like trying to be a label owner as well as an artist, and, you know, just break things that are new, just fresh, you know what I'm saying? We got Audio Push, K. Roosevelt, young guys that I'm helping to develop, and
nice.
I'm just trying to really provide some freshness to the game.
You've worked, I mentioned all these big artists. Who, you mentioned Britney Spears. Do you want to go down the pop route too?
Man, I do. I just feel like I got so much more to offer. And people, like, they're just really, like, starting to get all the way hip to, you know, what it is I do. And I feel like if I could just get to the point where I'm doing, like, half of someone's project, people will really understand, you know, what I'm able to bring to the game.
So a kid wanting to, you know, if a youngster asked you, you know, how can I get in the game and be a producer like Hit-Boy?
Man, just work hard. Like, that's, like, the number one thing. And just believe in yourself. Never give up, man. Like, it was, like, a lot of points where I was, like, ready to just, like, man, say forget this. But, like, you can't do it. You just got to keep working hard as possible, man.
See, what I understand is how in the hell are you going to have haters working with Kanye, Jay-Z?
Come on.
I
mean, but, like, they got haters.
Right, exactly. People hate on them. Like, so it's like, man, if people hate on Beyonce, like, how could you possibly hate on Beyonce? Like, there's no way. But, you know, if people can do that, then who am I? But, you know what I'm saying? You just right. got to stay positive, man, and that's what I'm on.
Right. Hey, well, much more success to you, man. You've already worked with some of the big names in music, Jay-Z, Kanye West, and I hope that Britney record comes and all those pop records. That way, you know, that bank account could get a lot bigger, dog.
Yeah, that's definitely needed.
All right, man. Well, anytime you want to stop by, the door's always going to be open.
Love,
man.
Appreciate y'all.
I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Hit-Boy! Yeah.